वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास स्टैंडर्ड 8 सब्जेक्ट साइंस लेसन नंबर 2 हेल्थ एंड डिजीजेस। सो स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी टाइप्स ऑफ डिजीजेस, मीन्स टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ टाइप्स ऑफ डिजीजेस। सो देर आर डिफरेंट types of diseases and each types of diseases falls in different categories. So we are going to see today the classification of diseases. Okay, so let's begin with its classification. Students, as you can see, we are going to learn today about types of diseases. Okay, so here, as you can see in the given figure, the types of diseases is classified into two part. The first part is according to duration and the second part is according to reason. Now what do you mean by according to duration? Duration means time, according to time. Okay, so according to duration, the disease is further classified into two type. The first one is your chronic disease and the second one is your acute disease. So what do you mean by chronic disease? Chronic disease are defined as it is the condition that lasts for 1 year or more than 1 year. Okay, as I've said you that this disease is according to duration, that is time. That is why the chronic disease is defined as the condition that lasts for 1 year or more than 1 year and required ongoing medical attention or limit. Okay, so this chronic disease is last for how many years? More than 1 year or 1 year. Okay, and it required lots of attention, medical attention. Now we are going to learn about acute disease. Now what do you mean by acute disease? Acute disease appears suddenly, means it is not long lasting disease. It just appears suddenly and lives for short duration of time. This acute disease appears suddenly and live for just short duration of time. Okay, there is difference between these two diseases. It is long lasting disease and it needs quite more medical attention, but in this acute disease it is short term disease. Okay, and it appears suddenly and it goes also very soon. It doesn't require more time. Okay, so now we'll be moving further with the next disease, which is according to reason. Because of some reason which disease happens is known as your according to reason. And according to reason, there are two parts. Okay, it is further classified into two parts. The first one is your hereditary disease and the second one is your acquired disease. Now what do you mean by hereditary disease? And the example is also given, Down syndrome. Now hereditary disease is such a disease which we get from our parents. Okay, parents, grandparents, like it is in our DNA. Okay, this type of disease is in our DNA which we are getting from our parents. And example they have given, Down syndrome. Down syndrome means what? Disease such as when the child take birth, it may be having mentally retarded or some kind of disabilities in his body. Okay, so such a disease is known as Down syndrome. Now acquired disease, disease which we have acquired. Okay, which we have acquired, which we have adapted, such disease is known as your acquired disease, and it is further classified into two types. One is infectious disease and the other one is non-infectious disease. Now what do you mean by infectious disease? Infectious disease is nothing but disease spread through contaminated air, water and vectors. Okay, so diseases is spread because of contaminated air, water, food or vectors So such a disease comes under your infectious disease. Okay. Now what do you mean by non-infectious disease? So student, non-infectious disease are such a disease which do not occur due to infection or any body contact, okay, of any other's body. So in non-infectious disease, the disease occur inside the body of human beings because of some reason. So what are the example for this? Like cancer, okay, cancer, diabetes and heart disease. Okay, so such a disease, they don't need any body contacts or any infection. This type of disease occur inside the body because of some reason. And what happened in infectious disease? Here the disease occur because of the contaminated of air, water, food and vector, okay, because of infection. So here they have given example for that is common cold, flu, dengue, malaria, virus, fever, okay. Such an example comes under your infectious disease. Okay, so we'll be learning about infectious disease and non-infectious disease in detail, okay, in the next slide. Thank you.